Are you serious? Are you serious? Russia's going to make its move. Russia, power play. Putin. What? Yes. According to reports, North Korea has the world undivided attention, and rightfully so. But as everybody's watching what next move Kim Jong-un is going to make with his hermit state in North Korea, Russia's president, Vladimir Putin, is seeking power elsewhere. He's making his move in the Middle East. Matter of fact, the Russians have made no secret of their attempt to make allies in the Middle East with the Iranians. And while the United States and NATO forces turn their attention to nuclear threats from North Korea, the Kremlin is focused on Syria. And they've been fighting ISIS terrorists in Syria as long has been part of the Kremlin agenda. But Putin is also building relationships not only with the Iranians, but with President Assad of Syria, which we've known that's been going on a long time. The Russian military announced today that they are liberating several little towns there in Syria. In a massive strategic defeat over ISIS, the Assad army is even making major inroads from some of the territory that ISIS has controlled for 3 years. And so over the past 2 months, the territories controlled by Damascus have grown. They're taking back more area. Now, part of that's because the United States also, because of our attempts to drive ISIS out of areas surrounding Raqqa, and also setting up no-fly zones to help the different groups fight against the ISIS fighters, including the Russians. So there's a lot going on in that part of the world. But remember this, Putin is not only focused on the Middle East and Syria, and because with Putin and Iran building this strong alliance, and with Putin forming alliances now starting to with Turkey, and with Ethiopia ready to go, and Libya certainly ready to go, the Fab Five from Ezekiel 38 is in play. They are the five nations plus others that be willing to go against Israel. Matter of fact, they're going to go against Israel at some point, according to the prophecy of Ezekiel 38. And so when you look at Psalms 83, you can see that these nations are forming these alliances. And the Bible says in Psalms 83, "Keep not thy silence, O God, and hold not thy peace, and be not still, O God. For lo, thy enemies have made a turmoil, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They've taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. They've said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. For they've consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee." This is what they will do. There's no question about it. They are forming confederacies against Israel. So, also, Putin is not done with Europe. He has put thousands, and I mean thousands, and he will build up to over 100,000 troops by late October all along the border with NATO countries like Poland, Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania, all along there. And so NATO is building up forces, and there's tanks, and there's rocket launchers, and there's planes, and there's bombers, and there's all kinds of activity going to be going on both sides of the borders there, as the Russians and the nations of NATO, including the United States and Germany, are all getting in position to make sure that they've got the back doors closed in case something breaks loose in the Pacific East. And we're watching it closely there with North Korea. What about China? What about Russia? Well, we just got some reports today that China is saying that if the United States does a preemptive strike on the North Korea, China will come in to defend North Korea. Now, if North Korea fires first, that's a different story. But if the U.S. does a preemptive, China said they will back North Korea. And you know this, Russia will too. So Putin's making a power move, and the Chinese are starting to get in position. Everybody's watching closely what's going to take place around the world. Give your life to Jesus Christ, because he said there would be wars and rumors of wars. And see that you be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass. The end is not yet. Nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines, pestilence, earthquakes in divers places. And all of these, just the beginning of the sorrow. Now, don't miss tonight. Sunday Night Live starts at 7 p.m. Eastern. The title of the broadcast, The Sky is Falling! 204 fireballs crashed through the Earth's atmosphere last night. An asteroid's going to whiz by our head today. And and here comes the great American solar eclipse. Here comes the Revelation 12 constellation signs in the heavens on September 23rd. The sky is falling. The signs are everywhere. Are you saved?